Well, thank you. Thank you, David. Now, well, good afternoon, good morning, depending on the time zone, everybody. I'll run through now what I want to cover in this short session. First, I'm going to go through the virtual private database. Virtual private database, it's also known by several other acronyms. Some people like to refer to it as row-level security. Other people use fine-grained access control, so VPD, RLS, FGAC. Powerful facility. It's also bundled up, by the way, as label security. It was first introduced in release 8i, and it just about worked. But back then, it had serious performance problems, and furthermore, wasn't really suitable at all for a web environment. And I think many people, myself included, tried it back with 8i and thought, this doesn't work, and gave up. However, in the later releases, particularly the changes that came in with 10G, it's become a very powerful capability indeed, which I would strongly advise everybody to look at. VPD, so we'll have a look at VPD. Oh, I should point out it's an Enterprise Edition. Then we'll move on to some 12C features, to a 12C feature, which is data redaction. New with release 12.1. Now, positioning data redaction against VPD, there is, as far as users are concerned, considerable functional overlap. But the technology, the underlying technology, is in fact completely different. The protection you get with data redaction is not as comprehensive as that provided by the VPD. In some cases, my attempts to reverse engineer it have found it may be possible to circumvent it in certain circumstances if the user is in a very privileged position. But compared to VPD, it is much simpler to implement, and I don't believe it has any performance issues. Redaction is licensed as part of the advanced security option from 12C onwards. Thirdly, a brief mention of data masking. Now, I don't think I'm going to have time to demonstrate data masking, but for completeness, I do want to mention it, because again, there's an overlap with data redaction, with virtual private databases, all in the same sort of area. But I won't have time to demonstrate that, I don't think. Now, the data masking, briefly then, unlike the other two, data masking actually changes data. Virtual private database restricts the data that people see. Data redaction conceals or hides the data. Subtle difference there. Data masking actually changes the data in the database. It's a permanent change. That makes it suitable for non-production systems. All those clones you make. You know, when you clone your databases to test systems, to development systems, to DSS query systems, and so on, you have to clean the data. You have to remove all the personal references so that people can't see any of the personal indicators as you move your data from production to the warehouse, from production to development. That's where data masking comes in, a permanent change made to the data, typically on clone systems that are generated from your production boxes. The reason I won't have time to demonstrate it is that with 12C it is pretty awkward. When data masking came in with 11G, there was a very nice graphical interface provided with 11G database control and no PLSQL interface. With release 12C, database control no longer exists, and there is not a data masking interface provided with Database Express. So to get data masking functioning nowadays, you need either grid control or cloud control. And I don't think I'm going to have time to switch over to that environment. But remember, it's there, and there is overlap with the other two functions. Then lastly, we'll move on to transparent sensitive data protection, TSDP. Now, TSDP is a very good front end that simplifies the pain of implementing VPD or data redaction. So what I'll run through is VPD, redaction, and then transparent database, transparent sensitive data redaction, which will make it so much easier to configure.